Hi guys, in today's session we are going to learn what is meant by swapping. So before going to that, I will explain the basic concept of multiprogramming system. So in multiprogramming system, we can store multiple process in main memory. Okay, we can store the multiple process, so the P1, P2, P3, P4, so all the process in main memory. So CPU can execute all the process. So CPU can execute all the process in efficient manner. So that advantages of multiprogramming is, so that CPU can execute in an efficient manner. So very simple. And then in multiprogramming system, we have to divide the memory. We have to divide the main memory into two parts. The first system, the first part stores the operating system. So the first part stores the operating system, whereas the second part stores the user process or the user part. User part. Okay, so here in multiprogramming, user part is divided into various parts in order to store the processes. So here the P1, P2, P3, P4, all these things we are storing, all the process we are storing in the user part. So here the two operations will be performed, CPU operations as well as the IO operations. Okay, so CPU operations and IO operations. So CPU instructions are executed in faster manner. So it will be executed in a faster manner, for example arithmetic as well as the logical instructions, whereas that IO operations are slow. Okay, so IO operations, input operation, output operation, or for example you can take that reading of some data or writing of some data, this is all related to the IO operations. Okay, so next, so process P1, process, for consider an example, process P1 is waiting for some IO operation. So process P1 is waiting for some IO operation. So during IO operation, CPU is idle. Okay, so because it's the responsibility of the operating system to perform the IO. Okay, all the IO operations, all these things, it will be performed by the operating system. So CPU will be idle, so that operating system allocates next process P2 to the CPU. So it means the process P1 wants to perform some kind of IO operation. So during that IO operation, so that CPU will be in the idle condition. So the operating system allocates next process, that is process P2, to the CPU. So if process, for example, if process P2 is waiting for some IO operation, then operating system allocates next process, that is P3, to CPU. Like that it's going to perform. So CPU is busy, so we can utilize the efficiency of CPU in an efficient manner with the help of this multiprogramming system. Okay, so next is that CPU can access only the content of main memory. So what all the contents is there in main memory, so that it will be accessed by the CPU. CPU can't access the content of secondary memory directly. Okay, so that CPU can execute a program if and only if it is there in the main memory. If it is there in the secondary memory, then it won't access. Okay, so next example is that if process P1 completes all its operation, then there is no need of CPU for process P1. So this process will be transferred to the secondary memory, and the transformation we can call it as a swap out. So if this process P1 completes all its operations, so all its operation for the process P1 is over, so then there is no need of CPU for this process P1. So this process P1, it will be transferred to the secondary memory. So it will be transferred to the secondary memory. So this transferring known as the swap out. Okay, this transferring known as the swap out. Okay, so that operating system transfers process to a secondary memory. So this is one example, very very important. And the example two is that if the process is waiting for some IO operation, so CPU is idle because there is no need of CPU at that time. So if this process, for example, this process P2, now we can take the process P2. So process P2 is waiting for some IO operation. So CPU will be idle in this IO operation. So CPU is in the idle condition because there is no need of CPU at that time, because there is no need of CPU for the IO operation, right? So operating system transfers the process from main memory to a secondary memory in this case. So the next thing, next example is that if process P3, next process P2 is over, next process P3 is trying to access operating system area of other process. Okay, if process P3 is trying to access the operating system area of other process, okay, if it wants to access the area of this P4, P2, P1, operating system generates a trap. Okay, so the operating, so that process will be terminated. So this process will be terminated. Okay, so terminated process moved from main memory to a secondary memory, so that process P3 can't access P1, P2, P4 area. Okay, so this mechanism is called as a trapping mechanism. Okay, so if the process P3 trying to access the another process area, then this process P3 will be trapped, and then this process will be moved from main memory to a secondary memory. So it will be shifted from main memory to a secondary memory. Okay, that's it. So next thing is that in round robin algorithm, we can take that. So we execute a process for particular time quantum. It means we are providing the particular time for each and every process. It means for process P1, we are allocating the time for 2 milliseconds. For that process P2, we are providing that 5 milliseconds. Like that, we are providing the time for each and every process. So if the time quantum completed, then there is no need of CPU for that process. So if that time has been completed, then there is no provision of CPU for that particular process. So CPU transfers the process from main memory to a secondary memory. So if that time limit over, then also the process P1, it will be transferred from main memory to a secondary memory. If the time over, then also if the process P2 time quantum is 5, means then after this time, then the process P2, it will be transferred from main memory to a secondary memory, like that. Okay, so next is that priority scheduling algorithm. For that, process P1 is low priority process. Process P1 is low priority process. While executing this process P1, high priority process came into a ready queue. CPU stopped the execution of that process P1. So if the process P2 is have the high priority, then so low priority P1 is transferred from main memory to a secondary memory. Main memory to secondary memory for the execution of high priority process. If the process, or if the CPU is free, then the process is transferred from secondary memory to main memory. This process is known as the swapping. So very simple. So the process P1 is low priority. Okay, low priority process. While executing this process, if high priority process P2 came into a ready queue, CPU stopped the execution of low priority process. So this process P1 is of low priority. So that's why P1 will be moved from main memory to a secondary memory. It will be moved from main memory to a secondary memory. So low priority process is transferred from like that. Then if CPU is free, then the process is transferred from secondary memory to main memory, and this process is known as swap in. So this is your swapping concept, and it's very, very important concept for your exam. Thank you.